Welcome guys to Boulder Town Martial Exhibition Day 6 with me panglimakegelapan. So in Day 6 we are gonna go to the form of heat with imaginary element. So let's go. This one is a bit tricky and also it's so conditional. So I will tell you some guide maybe. Okay, there's two guide. First, the main guide that I will show you, and the secondary. The secondary, I will not gonna show you, but I will tell you. So, here we go. The first character, the trial character that we are using, there is two in here. There's wealth and inhibitor online. In my case, if you are using both, or just using wealth, you are gonna using a lot of cycle. More than 5 cycle, so that's not an option for me, but it's up to you. Maybe you have a really good wealth build, but in my experience, because I don't have wealth and inhibitor night, so I will not using wealth at all. We will gonna focus on lunite. So there you go. The first buff that we got here, when imprisoned enemy are attacked, and if their toughness is depleting, it means that you are weakness break them. Their toughness will regenerate to 20% of their max toughness. So, let's say you weakness break enemy with inhibitor online and imprison them. Their toughness, you know, like the white mark up upper side of health, with being regenerate 20%, but the imprisoned effect are still there. It's gonna be useful later on, but for now, just take note on that. Okay. And there is four weakness break that you need to know right now. First, of course, imaginary. The second one is electric. The third one is ice, and the fourth one, I will tell you, wind. Because the third phase in here, you can see like progress, one of third. Okay, the third one, the last one, you need a wind. I mean wind. I'm using electric, and that's a really, really tough to reach like a 5 cycle. So, it's up to you if you have a really good like electric character. That's the secondary guide from me, but the main guide I will using win character. So let's go to all the character. First thing first, there is imaginary, win, ice, and electric. It's up to you for this one. If you have wo, if you can bump up inhibitor online with wo, but wo need an R. Other character need have more 20% of break what's called toughness break more than 20%. So yeah, you can use any character that are included in 4 element that I already said. In this instant, I will use blade because blade is so cheap. Because in every phase, like in between 3 phase that we are gonna going through, we are not gonna using more than 3 cycle. So blade is only gonna using 1 skill point. So he really cheap and quite good. It's a bit RNG. If blade being attacked 5 times, that's really good, but it's a bit RNG. So blade is just cheap one. He not the key. Just being there to fill the gap. The next one is gonna be our Mayan destruction. Here we go. Inhibitor Lunai. Here we go. He was main source of all the damage and also damage multiplier later on. The third one, this one is a bit tricky because we have inhibitor Lunai, so we need a lot of skill point. So you need a character like Blade, but we already had a Blade, so You need a character that has skill point neutral or skill point positive, like maybe Huo Huo or another character. But you can choose another character like maybe Bronya later on or Kafka. It's up to you. You can also use Clara if you want to. But the main point is you need a character that not taking a lot of skill point that Lunai really really need. So for this one, I will choose Jingliu, because Jingliu is ice. Also, see a skill point neutral. Just need two skill point. After that, we can attack two or three attack for free. Yeah, including the ultimate. Also, maybe you can think like, wow, that's gonna take some skill point from Lunai. Yeah, I know that, but here the secret sauce. Because in 1.5 phase 2, you have a good character that gonna give us some skill point, which is Hanya. In this guide, I'm using her a lot because she really, 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 really good to give us a lot of skill point. If you see all of my video, I'm using her a lot, almost all, maybe all if I'm not wrong. So there you all go. Because we have Hanya, we are not gonna thinking a lot about Jingliu taking some skill point from Inhibitor Lunai. So let's go. And remember, the day 6 is a bit RNG. We hope that Hanya being attacked or Inhibitor Lunai. These two is the one that, man, they are attacking Blade. Dang, man. They are attacking Blade. That's really bad because we really need Hanya. Like this one, it's a bit bad for now, man. It's really bad for now. The RNG part is that we need Hanya being attacked. Really, Hanya, not Blade. Blade is afterthought. We need Hanya to being attacked. Like, here we go. We almost full. Make Hanya full. Because we need only finish this first phase in one turn. So don't worry, we can read it again. Because the phase 2 and phase 3 are gonna take 2 cycles. We wanted to finishing this one in 5 cycles. So don't worry to if you needed to retreat and come back again. I hate this, is like this is a bit RNG, like we need Hanya being attacked, like, or Inhibitor Lunai. There you go. Hanya not being attacked again. So we are gonna retreat again. I hate it, man. I really hate. But Hanya is the secret sauce. There you go. I hope Hanya like being attacked like that, man. There you go. Okay, Hanya being attacked twice. That's really good. So we are gonna using Hanya skill. There you go. Now Hanya skill is almost full. There you go. That's our secret sauce. Okay, so we are gonna using skill for Inhibitor Lunai. There you go. Using Jingliu also. And here we go. We are not gonna using a skill for Blade because Blade just after thought. There you go. Inhibitor Lunai have a ultimate. Okay, here we go, Hanya. We're gonna using Hanya ultimate just in case. Here we go, Hanya ultimate on Inhibitor Lunai. There you go. In here, we are gonna using ultimate first. There you go. After that, we are gonna pump up him to the max. There you go. In here, depend on your character. Like if you have really really good imitator lunai, what it called? I'm sorry, a bill imitator lunai really good. You gonna be destroying here, destroying the enemy. Because like, in here, the trial one is quite bad. Like, use more welcome to you. So, you should be able to destroying it if you have inhibitor lunai. But unlucky for me, I don't have it. So I will using a Jingliu in here. So we are still in turn cycle one. Because we are using Jingliu, we using her skill first, and what now is the second one. So we have extra turn. There you go. There you go. If you are not destroying him in this attack, we can using the ultimate for Jingliu too. This is so good, man. This is so good. If you have Jingliu, please using her. There you go. She's not dead, but we have ultimate. I mean, the enemy not dead, not Jingliu. There you go. Still in one cycle. Okay, here the second buff. That is the right one. You gonna maybe you tempting to using it, like, but you know, like 200%. I know it, but we are not gonna using that. We are gonna using this one. After enemy receive break damage, the break damage multiplier they receive increased by 80%. This effect can stack up to 15 times. This one is 6 times. And also is only for imaginary, like, because affected with imprisoner. Man, that's a bit tough. And remember, the first buff is when you imprison the enemy, their toughness is gonna be regenerate. So after regenerate, we can imply another weakness like wind shear or frozen. So we are gonna use this one. So we are gonna imply multiple weakness on enemy. So here we go. Or electric, if you choose electric. Here we go. I know, there you go. Like, why you think wind? There is electric. The third one is the one that really tricky. You're gonna see it in the third phase. Here we go. Let's jump into it. Okay, in here we're gonna using two cycle. So in here we are not gonna bit like RNG like before. We are just attacking the main boss. So it's okay. It's all okay. In here we are not gonna attack like before. We are like, you know, like just everything in Lunai. In here you can use his skill, but in here I will just attacking hit the enemy with normal attack. There you go, Jingliu. And in here we are using blade. Here we go. Just one time. This is one time skill use, so it's good for later on. There you go. Okay, if you are using well, that's gonna be really bad, because if you imprison the minion, they are not gonna giving us some energy for ultimate. So well is a big no-no for me, but it's up to you, man. But remember, if you are using well, it's gonna be more than 5 cycle overall. There you go. In here, it's up to you. Like, in here, it's up to you. In here, I will choose Imbiter Lunai, like, to being buffed by Hanya. This is really good. This is really, really good. Like, you can use, like, more. But I will using just one. It's up to you, man. It's up to you. Here we go. We are gonna imply the weakness break. There you go. After this, we are gonna imply the second debuff for the enemy. There you go. With Jingliu. Jingliu also really good in here. Really, really good. Like, here we go. Once again, we are gonna implying the weakness break again. That's really good because the weakness break is gonna being like multiply. Here we go. Break damage vulnerable. It's gonna being stack up. We have 4 in here, so it's good. You can using blade again if you want to. Or another character, it's up to you. There you go, 2 cycle, and we are not even like close to the end. So there you go. You can use like a I've said, you can pop up like jingle Lunai to the max, depend on your character, man. If you have a Lunai, just pop him up. Okay, here we go. The third base, the third buff. Debuff. there is this one. I know it's tempting to use imaginary ultimate, man, but this is the tricky one. We are gonna using this one when the enemy is weakness broken. The weakness break effect of ally. Oh, okay, here we go. The weakness break of all its type weakness will also be triggered simultaneously. Here we go. In here, the weakness break. Let's say the enemy have 3 weakness break: ice, imaginary, and wind. Well, 3 of them gonna be triggers again and again and again. Remember that the enemy weakness tough break toughness is gonna be regenerate again and again and again. So it's really good. It's gonna be happen again, happen again, happen again. There's gonna be a bump up the second buff that we have before. So it's really, really good. In here, you can see why I'm using blade or any win character. You can use sample or whoa. Here we go. See, there is a wind character in the middle. There's a wind and imaginary. There you go. That's my my point. Why I'm using blade, not what is called electric? Because in here you can see there is no electric weakness in here. So there you go, man. Because the third one that maybe you will have tough time to deal with. So here we go. That's why I'm using wind character. Okay, let's jump into it. We only using 3 cycles, so we have 2 cycles, a bit leeway, so it's good. You need to remember the first one is the first phase. You should be finishing it in 1 cycle. I repeat, in the first phase, you need to finishing in 1 cycle because the second and third phase, you really not gonna finishing it in 1 cycle. Just remember that. Okay, in here, because we using hanya, so is hanya gonna contribute to weakness break too. So there you go. Also give us a skill point. There you go. In here, this is a bit tricky. It's up to you, but I will use a skill point, just 1. It's up to you. You can use skill point 1 or not. But I don't know. I think this is a bit RNG because inhibitor neuron is being a targeting, so also blade being target, I will change the strategy. Again, this is a bit RNG. If I'll attack towards Lunai, I will just use all the skill for Lunai. But in here, you can see all the target is being spread out. So I will not using Lunai, like all the Lunai skill point. I will spread everything to everyone else, like almost everyone. So I will just take. There you go. Using it for Jingliu, and also we are using skill for blade. So there you go. Take. There you go. Here we go. In here, we are gonna using main blade. Okay. We are gonna using inhibitor Lunai right away. This is a bit RNG. There you go. Blade using it, but it's okay. Inhibitor Lunai also. In here, okay. It's a bit tough. Yeah, it's a bit tough, man. This is also RNG right now. Okay, we have three in here, like three cycle. So, not three cycle, more than three skill point. So we are using him. There you go. And we are gonna weakness break this one. And using ultimate. There you go. We are gonna using it again. There you go. We have blade 2. In here, it depend on you. Like hanya gonna giving us some skill point, but it's up to you. You can bump up Jingliu Lunai, but in here I will bump up inhibitor Lunai. Jingliu, bruh! What's wrong with me? Remember, in third in phase 1 and phase 2, it's so tricky. It's so tricky. There you go. If you have a good Lunai, it's gonna be destroyed. But sadly, I don't have it. So here we go. There you go. Into cycle. So in total, I'm using 5 cycle. I know this one is a long video. So sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. There you go. Win it. Man, 20 minutes. I'm so sorry. But there you go. The 6th day. So thank you so much for all of you. If you like this kind of content, you can go to panglimakegelapan.start.page. In there, you can find all of my social media and how to support me. Or say hi when I'm live streaming on every platform. So thank you so much for your time. I know this is 20 minutes, but thank you so much. This one is tricky and a lot of RNG thing. So please, you're seeing it, man. Thank you so much. See you again in the last day. Okay. See you again next time. Bye.